Hello and welcome. I'm DK Geyer and I hold a dual doctorate in holistic natural health and nutrition. And today I'd like to talk to you about diabetes and the increased risk of kidney stones. When I listen to people's stories when they're diagnosed with type 2 diabetes, they all seem to have a few things in common. One, they do not have any idea how much sugar they are actually consuming, and they believe that they truly inherited type 2 diabetes from a family member. As you will see in this video, genetics plays a very minimal role in a type 2 diabetes diagnosis. But when reviewing their food and beverage choices, and truthfully figuring out what they eat and consume in an average week, they are stunned at how much sugar they consume. But they are empowered to embrace new eating habits because they truly want to feel better. And they want to feed their families wonderful, healthy choices. When you learn why and how kidney stones form in relationship to a type 2 diabetes diagnosis, it is much easier to drastically reduce your risk of forming them. So let's face it, no one wants the pain of having to pass a kidney stone. So if you are in a situation where you have type 2 diabetes and you want to learn and have an explanation of how those kidney stones are formed and what you can do, please stay tuned for this video. Are you concerned about developing kidney stones because you are a diabetic? Want to drastically reduce the possibility of forming stones? Well, of course you do. Let's face it, no one wants to experience the pain of passing a kidney stone. Learning how and why this situation happens will help guide you through making food choice decisions that can lower the chances of developing kidney stones. High blood sugar creates more than just a type 2 diabetes situation. Damage occurs in all organs and tissues in the body when sugar is consumed in excess. It destroys the health and livelihood of incredible people. Maybe it is wreaking havoc on your own life. There is a variety of factors associated with type 2 diabetes and kidney stones. Topping the list is dehydration, prescription and over-the-counter medications, and consuming too much animal protein. A person with A1C levels over 6.5% is 92% more likely to develop kidney stones than people without type 2 diabetes. Now that is an alarming statement. But let's delve into the science behind that information. The processed foods and lifestyle behaviors that promote type 2 diabetes also contribute to kidney stone formation and other health conditions. Kidneys filter toxins from the blood to keep us alive. When kidneys cannot function properly, the impurities accumulate in the blood and essentially threaten our existence. Kidney stone is a message that serious health conditions are imminent unless dietary changes are made. The food you eat can either be the safest and most powerful form of medicine or the slowest form of poison. Many food choices in the U.S. contain synthetic ingredients that our human bodies cannot recognize or use. These man-made food items burden the natural operations that help us function. Process and fast food become a form of poison. Many people believe they have type 2 diabetes because they were born with it. In fact, type 2 diabetes is rarely inherited. Only when the pancreas is damaged through a virus or infection, a physical injury, or debilitating disease such as cancer, only then does it become irreversible. Otherwise, type 2 diabetes is considered self-induced through food and beverage choices. The same is true for kidney stone development. Unless a person is diagnosed with cystorrhea, a rare disease, the only other way kidney stones form is through infection. Kidney stones are formed based on food and beverage choices. More than 95% of all type 2 diabetes diagnoses can be prevented or reversed. Making dietary changes is not always easy. Remind yourself why you are making a deliberate decision to avoid certain foods and beverages. Choose water with lemon instead of a refillable soda, sweet tea, or cappuccino. The water provides hydration without the added sugars, and it helps the kidneys perform their duties and remove dangerous toxins. Even though type 2 diabetes is preventable, it is growing at an astronomical rate, especially among children and young adults. But healthy choices can be confusing. Listen to this testimonial from Allison. It is featured in the Disease Defender Cookbook.
I was treated for diabetes for 5 years, one prescription after another. My mom was diabetic. I assumed, from things I heard, that diabetes was hereditary. When I saw a class for reversing diabetes, I was all about it. I hated being diseased. Dr. Geyer asked the students to write down what they ate for breakfast, lunch, dinner, and snacks. She walked through the steps of how to calculate teaspoons of sugar and how to identify the major sugar contributors in our diet. The carbs to teaspoons of sugar equation showed that my sugar consumption on an average day topped 85 teaspoons. I truly thought I was eating healthy. Fruited yogurt instead of donuts. Chicken or tuna salad sandwiches instead of hamburgers and fries. Pasta with tomato sauce instead of meat, potatoes, and gravy. My snacks were fruit roll-ups, tortilla chips, and salsa or dry cereal. I was convinced this diet was healthy, and I was so proud of myself for sticking to it. We looked up products on the manufacturer's websites for nutrition information and wrote down the total carbohydrates and serving size. This is where all of us nearly lost our minds. Strawberry yogurt changes into 6 to 7 teaspoons of sugar in the body. Fruit rolls, or fruit leather, is 5 teaspoons for one little pouch. I was eating 3 or 4 pouches as snacks during the day because they are healthier than candy. I was so wrong. I felt betrayed and ignorant and very mad. I was led to believe my diabetes was a disease to begin with, then to find out that changing my diet would change my diabetes status, and this information is not a secret. People do it every day. I fell victim to advertising and marketing. Since this is a testimonial, you can guess that I am no longer diabetic. I eat so differently and helped other people change their eating habits by watching my success. Hope you can do the same.
The new information Allison learned provided a different way to look at food choices. Here is the calculation for converting total carbohydrates into teaspoons of sugar. Find the total carbohydrate grams on the label, divide it by 4, and it will equal the teaspoons of sugar. So for example, 44 grams of total carbohydrates divided by 4 equals 10 teaspoons of sugar. That's the amount of blood glucose sugar when the carbohydrates are converted inside the body. The World Health Organization recommends no more than 6 teaspoons of sugar daily. To put that into perspective, 1 20-ounce bottle of soda contains 13 to 15 teaspoons of sugar on average. High fructose corn syrup is linked to diabetes, obesity, kidney stones, and sugar addiction. Please consider reading labels and eliminate products with high fructose corn syrup and added sugars. Living life with type 2 diabetes is stressful and costly. The sheer amount of time and money spent on medications, doctor appointments, insulin shots, and testing supplies is astonishing, not to mention the high cost of processed foods. Fresh fruits and vegetables are less expensive than sodas and snacks. There is another way to live. You can reverse a type 2 diabetes status, save some money, reduce the risk of kidney stones, and live a longer, healthier life. You deserve to be happy and healthy. Enjoy your everyday because someone special really loves you. Wishing you the very best, please just think about it.